Hello everyone, welcome to CADICAM C Tutorials. In this video, we will see how to import data from Excel to the MATLAB and how to plot graph using that data. So the first step is you have to go to the folder in which your Excel file is placed. So here on the desktop, in the folder of radiation data, I have an Excel file that is named as a radiation data. So here if we see the Excel file, I have data in the form of two columns. The first one is the temperature, second one is the intensity of radiation. And I want to import these two columns into the MATLAB and I want to plot that graph. Let me tell you one thing, that I have recorded this data at interval of 1 minute. So this is for first minute, this is for second minute and likewise. So first let us go to the MATLAB. Now here you have to go to the folder in which your Excel file is placed. So click on the browse for folder. Then I will go for the desktop and radiation data and select folder. Then click on the new script. Now here let me first place CLC. Now here, in order to import the data, you have to define one matrix in which you will be storing your data. So here this data I have taken in the month of May, so I will give name as May. So you have to give the name of the matrix, so I will give May equals to, then you have to write Excel as read, then into bracket in inverted comma you have to write the name of the file, the name of the Excel file. So here in my case, the name of the Excel file is here, radiation_data.xlsx. So I will type here as radiation_data.xlsx. Then outside the inverted comma, place comma. And then in inverted comma you have to specify the sheet name. So here if I open the Excel file, the name of this sheet is sheet 1. So I have to write the name of the sheet, that is sheet 1. After writing the name of the sheet, outside the inverted comma you have to place a comma, and then again you have to specify the cells that you want to copy from the Excel file. So here in my Excel file, I want to copy the data from this cell, that is A1, to this cell, that is B60. So here you have to specify the range in inverted comma, and that is A1 to B60, and then click on the run. Now you have to save the file, so I will give name as radiation data. You can give any name to the MATLAB file and then save. So here this is busy. Now here you can see that it has extracted all the data from the Excel file and it has saved into the matrix called as May. So here if you see, here a variable is created, that is the matrix, and the name of the matrix is May that we have written over here, and we have extracted data from A1 to B60 that is stored in the Excel file. So here in the matrix you can see that there is 60 rows and 2 columns. So the matrix created in the MATLAB is 60 rows and 2 columns. So here first we have created a matrix into which we have stored our data. Now here let me place semicolon. Now I want to store data. Here we know that the first column is for temperature, second column is for radiation. Now I want to store the data of radiation as well as temperature into the separate matrix. So I will define another matrix as capital T for temperature, and then I will assign some value from this matrix mayor. So here in matrix temperature equals to, I have to extract the data from the matrix mayor. So I will write here the name of the matrix from which I want to extract data. So I will write here mayor, then into bracket, here in the data of temperature I want to extract all the rows but first column. I want to extract this data from this Excel file or from this matrix, but I want to extract this first column, and for the first column there is 60 rows and first column. So here I want to extract data of all the rows. So here first I will place colon, then comma, and then first row, and then click on the run. So here you can see that the first row, I'm sorry, the first column of the matrix mayor is stored in the matrix called as T. And here also you can see that another variable called as T is added as a matrix having the 60 rows and one column. Same way I have to store the data of radiation into another matrix, and I will call that matrix as radiation intensity I. That equals to, I want to extract the data from the same matrix mayor, so I will write here mayor into bracket. Now here I want to extract the data from this matrix here, and I want to extract the data of second column and all the rows. So here I will write here that I want to extract data from all the rows, so colon, then semicolon, and here I have to write as number of column. So I want to extract data from second column, so I will type here 2, and then click on run. So here you can see that it has created another variable, that is very intensity of radiation I, and it has stored 60 values, and here you can see that the values are stored in the matrix I. So I have extracted the data from the Excel file and I have created two matrix. Now I know that in my Excel file I have recorded all the data for 1 minute interval. So first data is for first minute, second data is for second minute. Now after taking data from the Excel file, I want to plot the data again the time. So I have to create another matrix. So I will write name as a small t to the matrix. Now equals to, now I want to start my data from the first minute, so I will type here 1, then you have to type colon. Now the successive difference between the data is 1 minute, so I want to increase my data of time as 1 minute. So the matrix will start from 1, it will give increment of 1, and I have to make that matrix for 60 minutes, so here I will type as 60 and then semicolon. So here I have defined my time matrix, temperature matrix, and radiation matrix. Now I want to plot the graph for time versus temperature as well as time versus radiation of intensity. So here I will type as figure 1, and then I will plot the graph. So type here plot into bracket. First I have to type the x-axis, that is the time. So first I will give it time, then comma, and I want to plot the temperature against time, so I will write here capital T, that is temperature, and then semicolon. Now we'll run it. So you can see here that a graph is plotted, and in x-axis there is a time, that is from 1 minute to 60 minutes, from 1 minute to 60 minutes, and in y-axis there is temperature, and the temperature that we have stored in a variable of T. So if I want to change the color of this graph, then I can specify here comma, then inverted comma, and here now I want to make the graph of red color, so I have to type for small r, then run it. So I have changed the color of the graph red. Now I want to plot the graph of intensity of radiation in the same graph. So what I have to do is that I have to type here that hold on, then I have to type here for another plot, so type here plot. Now here the x-axis is same as time, so x-axis is time, and the y-axis will be here radiation of intensity, that is I, and I want to give the color as a blue, so type here small b and then semicolon, and then you have to give it hold off. So here this hold on and hold off is used to plot the multiple plots on a single graph. So now here we will run it, and you can see that here the graph is plotted. So x-axis is time, and here y-axis will involve both the data, temperature as well as radiation of intensity. So here in red color we have temperature, and in blue color we have intensity of radiation. Now if you want to give the name of the title, so you can give the name of title as title, and here in inverted comma, single inverted comma, you can give the name. So here I will give name radiation data versus time and click on run. So here you can see the title of the graph. You can give also name to the x-axis as well as y-axis. So here let me give name to the x label, and in bracket in inverted comma the x-axis is time, so I will write time into bracket 1 less than t less than 60, and here my time is in minute, so time in minute, and I will give the name of the y-axis as y label, and the name of the y-axis is radiation and temperature, and then I will run it. So here I have given the name to the x-axis as well as y-axis. Now here you cannot identify whether this is for radiation or for temperature, so you can insert here the legend. So click here insert legend, and here the legend is added, and now here you can add the name of the legend. So here I know this blue color is for radiation, so double click on data 2 and write it here radiation, and then click outside here, and 1 is for temperature, so double click on data 1 and write as a temperature and click here. So this is how you can import data from the Excel file. You can store in a matrix, and further you can use the data to plot the graph using the MATLAB. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. If you like my video, then please hit on the like button, share it, and subscribe to my channel CATCAMC Tutorials. Thanks.